Accompong, from the Akan name Ikeampong, is a historical Maroon village located in the hills of St. Elizabeth Parish on the island of Jamaica. It is located in Cockpit Country, where Jamaican Maroons and indigenous Taino established a fortified stronghold in the hilly terrain in the 17th century. They defended it and maintained independence from the Spanish and then later against British forces, after the colony changed hands. The people named their community Accompong after an early African Maroon leader. After years of raiding and warfare, they established their autonomy with certain rights for limited self-government by a peace treaty with the British in 1739. Since independence in 1962, the government of Jamaica has continued to recognize Maroon indigenous rights in this area. History. In the 18th century, Maroon leader Cujo is said to have united his people under the Kinda tree in their struggle for autonomy. This was the site for signing the 1739 treaty with the British. This legendary, ancient mango tree is still standing. 2009. The tree symbolizes the common kinship of the community on its common land. Accompong was likely settled in the 1730s, during the First Maroon War, when rebel slaves and their descendants fought a guerrilla war to establish independence against the British. Hostilities were finally ended by a treaty between the two groups in 1739, signed under British Governor Edward Trelawney. It granted Cujo's Maroons 1,500 acres of land between their strongholds of Cujo's Town, Trelawney Town, and Accompong in the Cockpits. While the treaty granted this land to Trelawney Town, it did not recognize Accompong Town. In 1756, following a land dispute between Maroons from Accompong Town and neighboring planters, the Assembly specifically granted Accompong Town an additional 1,000 acres of land. The treaty also granted the Maroons a certain amount of political autonomy and economic freedoms, in return for their providing military support in case of invasion or rebellion. They also had to agree to return runaway slaves, for which they were paid a bounty of $2 each. This last clause in the treaty caused tension between the Maroons and the enslaved black population. From time to time, refugees from the plantations continued to find their way to Maroon settlements and were generally allowed to stay. After the treaty, Cujo ruled Trelawney Town, while his brother-in-arms, Accompong, ruled Accompong Town. In 1751, planter Thomas Thistlewood recorded meeting Accompong, whom he called Capt. Compoon. The planter described the Maroon leader as about my size, in a ruffled shirt, blue broad cloth coat, scarlet cuffs to his sleeves, gold buttons, dot and black hat, white linen breeches puffed at the knee, no stockings or shoes on. In the decades that followed, after Cujo and Accompong died, control of the towns passed to white superintendents, who were appointed by the governor to supervise the Maroon towns. The Treaty of 1739 named Accompong as Cujo's successor. When Cujo died in 1764, Accompong tried to take control of Trelawney Town. The governor, Roger Hope Ellettson, asserted authority over the leeward Maroons. Ellettson instructed Superintendent John James to take the Trelawney Town badge of authority away from Accompong, and to give it to a Trelawney Town Maroon officer named Lewis. James instructed Accompong that he had authority only over Accompong Town. Accompong seems to have died in the decade that followed. In 1773, it was reported that the white superintendent had appointed Maroon captains Cranky and Munko as the officers reporting to him in Accompong town. When the Second Maroon War broke out in 1795, the Maroons of Trelawney town took up arms against the British colonial authorities, but the Accompong Maroons, under the nominal leadership of Captain John Foster, swore allegiance to the British. The Maroons of Accompong town fought on behalf of the British colonial authorities against Trelawney town. Accompong town suffered losses in the Second Maroon War. When Maroon Captain Chambers was sent to Trelawney town to secure their surrender, Captain James Palmer of Trelawney town shot him and cut off the Accompong captain's head. Militia Colonel William Fitch, newly arrived in Jamaica, ignored the advice of his experienced Maroon trackers. He led his forces into a Trelawney town ambush. Their warriors killed Fitch, many members of the white militia, and a number of Accompong warriors. Accompong town backed the winning side. After the Maroons of Trelawney town were deported to Nova Scotia, the colonial authorities granted Accompong the sole rights to hunt runaway slaves. But the Accompong Maroons were unsuccessful in attempts to disperse or capture the runaway community of Cuffy. Soon the colonial authorities reinstated slave hunting rights to the Windward Maroons. When Cuffy's group faded from the colonial records, other refugee slaves established a Maroon community in Cockpit Country in 1812. The community of Me No Sen You No Come also resisted attempts by the Accompong Maroons and the colonial militias to disperse them in the 1820s. The Accompong Maroons played a significant role in helping the colonial militia of Sir Willoughby Cotton to put down the Christmas Rebellion of 1831-2, also known as the Baptist War, led by Samuel Sharp. Topic: Government. In 1739, the Maroon community was granted certain rights and autonomy by treaty with the British colonial authorities in 1739. In two settlements, they set up a traditional form of village government drawn from their Akan and Asante cultures, based on men popularly recognized as leaders. The executive is now called Colonel-in-Chief, who leads the Maroon Council. These men share executive responsibilities for the community. 1720s to 1770s Captain Accompong. C. 1773 Captain Cranky. C. 1773 Captain Munko. 1790s–1808 Captain John Foster. 1807 Major Samuel Smith. Topic: Late 20th century to present. Since Jamaica gained independence in 1962, it has recognized the political and cultural rights of Maroons. In the early 21st century, the government has acknowledged these rights in terms of the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples 2007, including the right to maintain and strengthen their distinct political, legal, economic, social and cultural institutions. It also acknowledges the right for self-government in matters relating to local affairs, as well as ways and means for financing autonomous functions. In 2009, Farron Williams was elected as Colonel-in-Chief of Accompong. Williams was elected to a second 6-year term in 2015. He appointed Timothy E. McPherson Jr. from Nanny Town to consolidate relations across the Maroon communities as part of a collective effort to protect the environment and promote climate change awareness.
Culture.
The inhabitants of Accompong share practices and traditions drawn from their Akan and Asante ancestors of 200 to 300 years ago, and combined with Taino. These practices have evolved as the Maroons adapted to local conditions. Descendants of the Maroons and Friends celebrate annually on January 6 both the birthday of Cujo, leader in 1739, and the treaty that granted their autonomy. In 2007, attendees at the festival protested increased bauxite mining, in an effort to protect the environment of their region.
See also:
First Maroon War.